pueblo débil, un pueblo blandengue, un pueblo cobarde, se rinde y vuelve a la esclavitud. Pero un pueblo digno, un pueblo valiente como nosotros no se rinde y no vuelve jamás a la esclavitud.
Well, comrades, first of all, I would like to thank all of you, as usually attend to this event to celebrate, among others, the anniversary of the attack of Moncada Barrack. This year, 64 anniversaries. It is a pleasure for me, as usual, to come here and to share with you and my colleagues from the embassies here present. And I just want to point out that our comrade Harper mentioned that we are tired of the imperialism, and we will keep being tired of the imperialism as long as we keep independent. That's the way it is. Because it's not a matter of being socialist or not. It is a matter of being independent. And if you don't join the imperialism in their point of view, so you have been tired. Other issues nowadays, as you must know, the new administration, the new U.S. administration, has been trying to reverse some of the advantages, some of the measure that before the former administration, Obama administration, took in relation with my country.
Yeah.
Effective immediately, I am canceling the last administration's completely one-sided deal with Cuba. Little Havana. This is very important. And you watch what's going to happen. We will not lift sanctions on the Cuban regime. We will enforce the ban on tourism. We will enforce the embargo. Easing of restrictions on travel and trade does not help the Cuban people. Effective immediately, I am canceling the last administration's completely one-sided deal with Cuba.
And still trying to reinforce the blockade against my country. And nowadays, maybe you are aware that an issue has arise here in UK related with the extraterritorial effect of the blockade. Because it's not just the matter of the blockade from the US against my country. It is a matter of the extraterritorial effect of the blockade.
Débil, un pueblo blandengue, un pueblo cobarde, se rinde y vuelve a la esclavitud. pero un pueblo digno, un pueblo valiente como nosotros no se rinde y no vuelve jamás a la esclavitud.
And here in Britain, recently was denounced by the Cuban Solidarity Campaign the rejection of one Cuban student to get into the Open University here in Britain because he's Cuban, nothing else. So they has been following the American law and put it aside the British law. And in our special case, it is a very shame to forbidden somebody to study just because it is Cuban. When Cuba, my country, has been delivering so many scholarships all over the world. And a lot of people, a lot of people have been graduating there from the very beginning of the revolution, even the American. More than 160 Americans has been graduated there in Cuba as a physician. So why just one Cuban can be can study here in the open university? If it is open, why not? Okay? So it is an example recently that had reached the press, even the Telegraph and the Guardian, that shows that the blockade is still in place. And we had to continue fighting to defeat the blockade. And we and we ask you again and again to support us in the solidarity that you have been giving us through the years to put an end of this blockade, because a country who deliver social care, as my own country does, doesn't deserve be blockade. A country who deliver solidarity in the health care all over the world doesn't deserve be blockade. But that's not enough. We have to fight. We don't have to ask. We have to fight and denounce to defeat the blockade. So, comrade, I just want to say thank you for the support that you have been giving through this year to my country, to my Cuban revolution, and asking you to keep that way. Thank you.